host sectionals, there's one more step before the state meet. But taking it lightly will get you taken over. Marion High School hosted Tuesday's regional meet. 2.5 dozen teams had at least one entry into the field, a field that Northrop beat pretty handily to win this year's regional title.
This team is so special. We're a great group of individuals. We all, to whether it's an individual event or a relay, we all work together. We always pull through and we're always supporting each other.
Hey, we proved, we did something today. We said something on the track field. Hey, Northrop's here. We're gonna show y'all something.
The Bruins won 5 events, and in 2 of those, they actually took the top 2 spots. The 4x1 relay, for example, wasn't even close. Tajay McKenzie, the anchor, just busting it, dusting the rest of them. Northrop's team won by 2 whole seconds, finishing in 47.64 seconds. That's a PR for these girls. But also coming out of the 4x1 was Wayne. The Generals got 2nd place by running a 49.88 on Tuesday night, so they'll also get to run this relay at the state meet. McKenzie ran another good 100 meters on her own and took home that event with a personal best time of 11.99. She was blazing. She beat out Leo's Karis Davis, who ran 100 meters in 12.13 seconds for 2nd place. Another Northrop runner, Cammy Bombersback, she got 4th, and Concordia sophomore Paige Jackson ended up in 5th. So who knows, maybe you'll see those two at the state meet alongside automatic qualifiers McKenzie and Davis. Now, Morgan Patterson has been smashing both hurdles events, and that did not stop at the regional round either. The 300 hurdles was all hers. It was closer than it may look. Leo's Leah Hanshu trailed by not quite a full second, but it never looked like Patterson wouldn't win the race. Her time, 44.54, a PR. Hanshu's time, 45.27, so they're both qualified for the state meet. And right there on the edge is Homestead junior Ryan Parrish. She got 4th place with a time of 45.98. And in the 100 hurdles, Patterson and teammate Kobe Scott will be wearing orange and brown to Indianapolis to battle the best in the state in that race. Patterson won in a time of 14.42, beating out the PR she set last week. And Scott got 2nd with a time of 14.8. Hanshu again in the mix. She may just be representing Leo after setting a school record and finishing in 4th, and also right on the cusp. Northside's Jalea Page, who got 5th, and Homestead's Parrish, who got 6th. That same thing happened again in the long jump with the 1-2, another event Northrop has just nailed this year. The sophomore McKenzie jumped the longest at 18.3, and Patterson's 17 feet, 4.75 inches was closest to that. The junior got silver in the long jump. All of that, and Northrop's girls don't even think they've reached their full potential yet.
We have talents everywhere, and we're not even at our best potential yet. We're not even at our breaking point yet. We have a lot of time to get better before state.
Carol actually beat out Northrop for the sectional title last week, if you remember. That's why their coach has blue hair right now. But on Tuesday, the Chargers couldn't overcome the barrage of Bruins points. They did, however, get a high jump W from senior Addison Smith. Smith won the sectional last week with a jump of 5 feet 2 inches. This time, she was the only jumper at the meet to get 5 feet 1 inch. And she's now a regional champ, even after battling a stress fracture in her foot almost this entire season.
It's really cool, it's an amazing experience. I'm really happy to be here, really happy to go down state with some of the girls. Just really excited.
We'll get to some of those other girls as we go along. Homestead also won a sectional title last week. They were the best team at the sectional hosted by New Haven. On Tuesday, Homestead was present in a lot of events and had a lot of success with 2 in particular, 1 individual event and 1 team event. Spartan senior Josie Gary, the individual winner by a wide margin in the pole vault. She jumped 12 feet 3 inches in 1 try. Eventually, she attempted 12.7, but no dice. That's okay, because no one else jumped more than 10.9. So Gary followed up her sectional title to also become the regional champ. Now, a couple spots behind Gary was Carol's Isabella Hoagland, who got 3rd in the event to qualify for the state meet. Hoagland got over 10.9 to claim that spot. Also worth noting, Dwenger senior Elise Hune tied for 4th in the pole vault, and Homestead freshman Allison Searks was 6th. Both jumped 9 feet 6 inches on Tuesday. Now let's take it to the 4x4 relay, which the Spartan team came into having the sixth best time. After one lap, they're right there in the mix with Concordia and Dwenger, those three leading the way so far. And after the second lap, you can see that Leo is in the mix too. But by the final handoff, Homestead establishes that lead, and about the last 200 meters or so was when that lead really ballooned. The Spartans won the race in 4 minutes and 2.9 seconds, a whole second faster than Huntington North, who got second. The final automatic qualifier was Leo. The Lions got third with a time of 4:05.92, and that sets a school record and makes this Leo 4x4 team the first to ever qualify for state, only the school's second state-bound relay team ever. Also right there in the mix was Concordia, who finished fourth at 4:08.16. Leo also left Marion with a regional champ on Tuesday night, not to mention four total school records. One of them was Davis's second place finish in the 100, and another was her victory in the 200. Wayne's Michelle Hurst, pretty much step for step with her though. This one was determined by 14 hundredths of a second. Davis, 25:35, Hurst, 25:49. On the outside looking in terms of automatic qualifiers, Grace Stedge of Homestead got fourth. She ran a 26:45, and Carol's Delaney Floyd got fifth by running a 26:62. Both of those times could play for a spot in the state meet. And going back to Karis Davis, I don't think I can overstate how important she has been to this record-setting Leo squad.
Oh, absolutely. She's huge for our team. I mean, tonight she scored probably 20 to 30 points on her own, and she helped us contribute to other ones. Team, she's all about the team right now because she doesn't like to run that 4x4, but as you can see, she has split a 57 for us, and that got us to state, so very exciting.
And you know what? It's time we just go down the list and see who else qualified with the top three spot. So let's take it to the 400-meter dash. Denia Grady of Northside, the sectional champ last week. She's only a freshman, and a couple big hitters from Homestead as well. This one was close. The top four spots determined by less than half of a second. You see Grady right there at the front. Homestead's Elena Necht also setting the pace. But in that far lane, Garrett's Natalie Armstrong makes a final push for the regional title. Her time, 1 minute and 29 hundredths of a second. Necht got second, and she ran it in 1 minute 38 hundredths of a second. Grady was third, so she still qualifies, and she ran it in 1 minute 59 hundredths of a second. Couple Carroll girls, Mary Beth Hall and Anna V, they were hanging around at the 5 and 6 spots in that event as well. Now on over to the 800, where Huntington North's Addison Wiley, now a senior, was a state runner-up as a sophomore in 2019 in this event, and on Tuesday night, she proved why. After lap, it's Wiley and everyone else. She finished almost 6 whole seconds ahead of the field. Behind her, though, Concordia senior Abby Mays pushing for a second-place finish, and she got it in a time of 2:16.15. Dwenger senior Nora Steele also on the podium with a time of 2:16.67, good for third place. The Magnificent Mile up next, and through two laps, Carol's Shelby Chrisman in the pack at the front. Remember, Chrisman won a sectional crown in this race last week. And by the start of the final lap, here's Chrisman making a move into second place, really putting the pressure on. But that pressure is nothing Addison Wiley can't handle. Wiley once again got first, and Chrisman coming in for her second place finish. Very nice effort to get to that point. She finishes the mile in 5 minutes, 2.09 seconds, which was a second and a half slower than Wiley, but still good enough to qualify for the state. Then the final individual race, the 2 mile. Homestead freshman Addison Knobloch won the 2 mile race at New Haven last week to become a sectional champ. Well, here we are in lap three, where Knobloch again right at the top, joining her toward the front, Carol's Chrisman and Ashlyn Minton, as well as Southside's Lauren Walda. Fast forward one lap, starting to thin out a bit at the top, Ashlyn Minton now in second, Knobloch in fourth. Minton falls back some to fourth by the seventh lap, and the Spartan freshman still right up there at the start of the final lap. Here's where Knobloch locks in. She's going for it, makes her move to first place, and she held it until maybe the final 50 meters before Norwell senior Lauren Bales, the favorite coming in, she kicks it back into gear, passes up Knobloch, and Bales gets the win. saw some trading, but Knobloch's time still good for second and a spot in the state meet. She finished in 11 minutes, 7.42 seconds. The Carroll pair, Chrisman and Minton, they finished 4th and 5th respectively, so they both still have a chance to make that state meet as well. One more relay to look at, and that's the 4x8. We'll pick it up at the end of the second lap. Dwenger Senior Steele battling Norwell's leadoff girl. She fell behind just a bit by this first handoff, and at the end of lap 3, Norwell has increased that lead. Dwenger in 2nd, but teams like Concordia, Leo, they're closing in. At the end of lap 5, Concordia is now in 3rd, Leo in 4th, Dwenger has fallen to 5th. Final lap. Norwell and Huntington North had secured the top 2 spots, but here comes Concordia, who ended up getting 3rd. The Cadet 4x8 team finished with a time of 9:46.45, and they'll get the chance to run that race at the state meet. It's possible Leo will too. The Lions finished 4th in the 4x8 at 9:58.72. And Dwenger, by the way, ended up getting 6th place. So some things we haven't mentioned yet. For Snyder, Naisha Anderson qualified in the shot put by placing 3rd. She threw it 40 feet 5 inches, and she also got 5th in the discus. And sticking with Snyder, high jumper Simone Bird tied for 4th in a 5-way tie, actually. She got over 4 feet 10 inches to give herself a chance at a state bid. We did mention Northside a bit. You know about Denia Grady already, but junior Tasia Cheney also mixed up in that 5-way tie in the high jump, and the freshman Paige's time of 15:05 in the 100 hurdles might just get her a spot in Indianapolis for the state meet. Southside got points from 3 girls on Tuesday. The junior Walda, who we briefly mentioned when covering the 2-mile, she finished that race in 8th place, actually recording a PR in the process, a big PR, I was told. Sophomore Jacqueline Embry got the same place in the mile race, and sophomore Grace Gilly tied for 7th in the pole vault by clearing 9 feet. Lures didn't get any points in the meet, but they did compete in 2 events. Sarah Bush got silver in the sectionals rendition of the 2-mile. On Tuesday, she finished in 10th place. And the Knights 4x8 team also got to compete. They too got 2nd at the sectional, but they ended up in 9th in Tuesday's regional meet. Now, I know we didn't get to cover all the times of those girls who may end up as callbacks to the state, so please, please check out the Crossroads timing web address included in the description. We'll be seeing plenty of these familiar faces in Indianapolis, and hopefully, we'll see you there too. Until then, this has been Blake Baker with Summit City Sports.